Let's flash back to 1995. Maná, the Mexican rock band, was in town. And like any other girl my age, I was in love with El Vampiro, who was the guitar man. And they were making a huge success with their song, Rayando el Sol. Oh, Celación. So I was there, and I could look straight into the stage at the concert, and I swear the vampiro was looking at me. Of course he wasn't looking at me. But my friends were next to me, and they couldn't see a thing. They were moving from one side to another, trying to see something between the backs of everyone. And you know what? That was the first time in my life that I was so happy to be tall. I was like, wow, this is amazing. I can see everything. But that story was not always like that. My story actually begins when I got into elementary school. And when I was 6 and I got into school, kids let me know that I was different. I was too tall to be their friends. I was too chubby to be in their class. I was too slow, and I was too burra to learn. So I just hated so much to go to school because they used to call me names all the time. Like, you have a piggy nose. Every time you walk, everything moves because you're too heavy. We don't want you in our team because you know what? You're too slow. And like, if that wasn't enough, I have a terrible problem putting attention in class, and I was diagnosed with hyperactivity and attention disorder. So, and as I was told, I needed to sit back all the time at the back of the classroom. And guess what? My learning troubles got even worse. So I remember those were very hard times. When I was between 8 and 9 years, I even thought about suicide. But what always was on my mind were my parents. And my mother was, because she will always say, Laura, you have to be intelligent for life, not intelligent for school. Just pass the classes, doesn't matter. You're going to be good at something at some time in your life. So that's what I did. I tried to go through. I went through school trying to be intelligent for life, just passing class. That was good with my parents. It didn't matter if I was a 6. I will just pass. So I remember this problem just was always in my life. And when I turned 15, I didn't have a quinceañera. I was signed into a diet clinic so I could lose weight. And that's the beginning of my story with weight. Coming up and down, a diet, another. I can make you any diet, the diet of the moon, the diet of el repollo, any diet, I know them all. And my story was always up and down with weight. And at some point, I just felt like I was always on a diet and always fat. I was sitting with my friends, eating salad. Everyone was eating hamburgers. And there is times when your body doesn't work the way you wish, that your metabolism and your emotions are different to other people. And the bad thing about that is that sometimes people can be very hard to judge you, especially talking about weight. When they look at you, they are like, oh, she doesn't love herself. Look at her size. You have no willpower. If you had willpower, you wouldn't be like that. You should make a diet. And I have heard that my whole life. One of the toughest moments I went through was when I was in college. And I needed to have a paper very early in the morning. We were supposed to meet with the teacher outside the cafeteria, and there was another girl from another class that I never saw before. And she was smoking like crazy, one cigarette after another, one cigarette after another. And when the professor arrived, he said, hey, you should stop smoking. It's very early in the morning. You should be having breakfast instead of being smoking. You're going to get cancer. The girl looked at me, head to toes, and said, I'd rather have cancer than being fat. I went back home, crying the whole way, because I couldn't believe it. Really? When people look at me, they prefer to have cancer than being like me? Is this real? Why people have to be so mean? So, you know what? I turned it out to be very intelligent for life. I was great on my profession. I finished college and I got a scholarship from the Rotary Foundation, and I was sent to New Zealand to study a master's degree in journalism. When I got back into my country, I began to write a column that became very popular. It was a Sunday syndicalized column. It was published by the Organización Editorial Mexicana in several states of Mexico and turned out to be a book later on. When I turned 30, I found out that all my goals in life were for before I was 30. The last one was a book, and I was getting my book published. So I was like, what is coming after 30? What is life after 30? And in a moment I thought, everything I have ever wanted my whole life is to be a petite, thin girl that the girls that started with me in elementary school. All I ever want has been to be thin, to get into a normal size. So I quitted my job. I quitted my book. I quitted my, I even sold my car so I could have money to take a sabbatical year. I quit everything. And I dedicated myself just to make right decisions on my eating, to get emotional support. And after almost 15 months, I was able to lose 110 pounds. This picture, we're in a holiday, we were in Cozumel with my family, and I swear, that was the first time I wore a bikini, and I was so excited. I didn't care about nothing. I put my bikini on, and I went to the malecon and ran as fast as I could. I didn't care about all the lost skin. I mean, you lost 110 pounds. There is consequences about it. So I was running, and my skin was coming up and down, and my brazos de murciélago. I didn't care about anything. I was so happy and so empowered, and I made my dream come true. I was, for the first time, getting to a store and just using a normal size. The doctor told me, you are not getting under a size 8 because of your tall and your bone structure. I went to a size 4. And I was able to stay that way for about 5 years. But I need to tell you something. There were times that I even cried because I was hungry. I couldn't eat more than 1,200 calories per day. I needed to work out 2 hours daily, including Saturday and Sunday. I was living just to be thin, because that's the way my body works. And at some point, I felt like, I'm an intelligent woman. I have so many talents, and all I can do is to be thin? I have really to dedicate myself to be thin. Later on, I got married, and at some point, my husband and I decided that we wanted to become parents. And I knew that with a child in my life, I wouldn't be the priority anymore. And I knew the consequences of not being the priority and having the time for myself. And I have this amazing child. And I also had about 70 pounds coming back to me. But you know what? When I look back to those times and that Laura that began with those processes, I'm a completely different person. Because during all this time, I have to learn to love myself the way I am. To love these arms, even if they are big, because they let me hold my kid. Yes. To let this... to love these legs, because they keep me on the floor, and they let me play. And to love this brain and this body the way it is. And I have learned to accept myself. When I was first asked which princess I should identify, I thought, you know what? I identify with Cinderella because she was all the time bullied by her stepsisters. Yeah. And because she never gave up, and I never give up. I don't know if I'm gonna be back at size 4 or at 8, but I don't care. I keep on eating healthy. And I never thought that my biggest insecurity will turn into my greatest asset. During all this process, I began a YouTube channel in 2011. where I talk openly about my problem with overweight, about dealing with bullying, where I'm able to talk to mothers who have kids who are suffering from bullying, where I'm talking to people with diabetes, with high cholesterol, that they go to a doctor, to a nutritionist, the skinny people that have never had this trouble, and they say, it's very easy. Don't eat tortilla, don't eat azúcar, eat less calories, and you're gonna get thin. Oh, sure. We're Mexicans. What do you want us to eat? The first one. So I have learned how to cook what I like so people with diabetes, with high cholesterol, can eat it. And now, today, I'm able to help more than 850,000 followers on YouTube. And over a million on my social media. And I'm always receiving messages, very grateful people saying, I have gone through what you have gone. And this is the first time that I feel identified, because it's hard to talk about situations that hurt you. And when I thought about Cinderella, that's what happened. I thought she was bullied, but she never gave up. But you know what? Today, nowadays, I identify with Cinderella, because at the end, I got the prince, I got the castle, and every day I get the option to live happily ever after.